Okay, I don't know if this is common knowledge or not, but I just discovered this feature in Zapier that I had to share. If you've used Zapier, you probably know that automations can be total game changers when it comes to repetitive or recurring tasks and setting up automations just to work faster and more efficiently and just get rid of the manual, tedious, rote work. But I just discovered that Zapier has a feature called Buttons, which you could plug into your Chrome browser and essentially set to do a wide variety of things. So I want just to quickly share how this works. The main use case that I'm using it for is if I'm on a particular site and I want to revisit it or turn it into a task, I could just click my Zapier button and then add that to my task database. So we're going to get into how it works, how to set up your button, where to find it in your browser, and hopefully you could use it for different purposes apart from just logging tasks. Maybe you're saving articles to read later or to add to your library, things like that. So I'm gonna get into how this works and jump in. If we haven't met, I'm Dave DeCespedes. I'm a certified Notion consultant. I work with clients, primarily startups, on everything from building workspaces to migrating to Notion to setting up automations, integrations, all that good stuff. So if we're just meeting for the first time, definitely subscribe if you're interested in more Notion and productivity content, and follow me on socials, which I'll add the links to those below. Okay, so a couple windows that we're gonna wanna have open in our browser. I'm using Chrome, but this works with any Chrome-based browser like Arc or Brave or many of the other ones out there. So first is gonna be our Zapier screen. So we're gonna log in. So we'll go ahead and do that here. We've got our home screen where we have our Zaps, the apps that are connected, all that stuff. Second window that we have open in our browser is some task database. We're gonna be using this as an example to basically click our button in our browser to add a task to our database. So here, this is just kind of grouping by date and filtering so that it's, you know, not showing stuff that's super old. So the first thing we're gonna do is in a new tab, we're gonna type Chrome extensions. Let's look for those. Let's go to the web store. And then we're gonna look for Zapier. This is the very first one, which is just called Zapier. We're gonna add this to Chrome. And now once that's loaded, we'll see it at the top right. Once that's downloaded, let's go ahead and open our extensions. We're gonna pin this to the browser so that it shows up regardless of whatever tab we're in. So when we click the Zapier button, we'll see here if we don't have any buttons set up, it will give us some recommendations. In this case, it's giving Notion recommendations because my workspace is tied to my Zapier account, but also things like sending a URL to your phone, shortening a URL, things that maybe require multiple manual steps that we could shorten. You can have multiple buttons. So this is a great opportunity, especially if you work a lot in your browser, to set some of these in advance and make them easily accessible from your browser. We're gonna create a new one from scratch. So we're gonna click Create Zap. We'll see here, this is creating a new automation in Zapier where the first step is automatically set to a trigger event, which is new push of the button. So here, this is our only option. So we're gonna click Continue. And here, we're gonna leave this blank. This just allows us to further customize if we wanna add specialized text in the button to run in a certain way. We'll leave that blank and go to Test. We haven't used the button yet, so we'll just click this to have it pull a record and continue with this record. For the second step, we're going to look for Notion. And to recap, any time we click the button, we're going to grab that web page that we're on, also grab the URL and add that as a task in Notion to our task database. So from here, we added Notion as a second step. We're going to choose an action, which is going to be to create a database item. Because our tasks live within a task database. For accounts, if you are part of multiple accounts, you just wanna make sure that you select the right one. This is going to bring in the name of the workspace. So once we have that in, we'll click continue. And from here, what we wanna do is look for the specific task database that you're using. In this case, I'm using that little degree symbol because I've got many different demo databases and things in my workspace. So I know that this is the right one. And then once we connect tasks, we start to see the properties that are part of that database. In this case, we want the task to have a name. So if we click in this plus button, this is pulling in all of the data from that tab that we have open, specifically the tab title, which is what we're going to use for the task name. Status, we're going to set this to inbox and then create a new inbox view of our task database back in Notion so that we could see things that have been brought in, but maybe haven't added any useful details to those tasks. So we'll do that next. And if we head down to the URL property, we're going to add the tab URL. So whatever website we're on, we're going to bring in that URL in case we need to open it later. And we're going to keep this simple, so we're not going to add any additional information for properties. If we kind of open this plus button, we could see that the four options don't really need the timestamp or the triggered by user. Maybe one other thing to note is maybe tagging myself so that this shows up in my tasks. So I'll tag myself here and then press continue. So once we have this, this is just a quick review of what the button is doing, what we're filling in, and what is empty. So now when we test this automation, we're going to click publish, and then we're going to test this out on a new tab in our browser. So in this case, we are on an article that we found via, say, an email newsletter, and we want to go back to it later on, but we don't have time to read it now. So we're going to go to our Zapier button and click send. Actually, while we're here, we're going to update the name of this so that we know what this Zap is doing. So we're going to say send web page to Notion tasks. So that updated automatically. Let's go back to our article and refresh. So now when we open our Zapier Chrome extension, we could see if we have multiple buttons, they'll show up here altogether. And then we're going to click send. And next thing we're going to do is go back to Notion, create an inbox view so that we could test to make sure that this article went to our task database. We're back in our task database, and what I want to do here is set up a new view. So in this case, this current view is really just sorting by anything that is to do or in progress and is within the last month. But we're going to duplicate this to keep the list format, and we're going to call this inbox. Let's update the icon here. And a couple things we're going to want to change are, number one, we're going to get rid of this grouping. So we're going to turn that off. So we have a bunch of tasks in here. And then the filter, instead of saying anything that's not an event, we're going to change this to the status being anything that's in our inbox. Let's turn these off and then click save. And then the one other rule, which is the date related rule, we're going to remove this just to make sure that our new task shows up. And then let's save for everyone. When we open up our task, we could see here that it's grabbing the URL and tagging me in this new task. And then when we open the URL from here, we can read that article, go back, and then when this is completed, mark it as done. And then now that's removed from our inbox. A couple things that we might want to do, if especially if we're setting up an inbox view, is decide what properties we want to have visible from here, so without having to jump into the page. So in properties, if we head to the URL, let's turn that on. And then if we want to tie this to a project from the inbox, let's kind of look for the project. Oh, it's already turned on. Great. So let's move that here. Maybe let's turn off the date and turn off the time estimate so that when we're in this page, when we click on the pencil edit icon, we can add a project. And maybe if we're writing an article on, say, the state of AI, we can tie this to that project so that it shows up on that project page. So that's just a quick overview of how Zapier buttons work, but definitely a lot of potential use cases for this, especially if we want to quickly grab things from our browser and send them to where we store our tasks, or if we have a read later space, whether that's in Notion or another tool, and kind of do it in as few clicks as possible. So let me know what you think. Are you planning on using Zapier buttons? Curious, other than adding tasks to your task database, other ways that you're thinking about using it? Would love to hear those if you want to drop those in the comments. And otherwise, hope that was helpful, and see you in the next video.